there are two computer science programs. There's a BS through the engineering school, and there you'd be taking the intro to engineering classes and getting a BS. It's a little bit more technical. And then there's a BA offered through the College of Arts and Sciences. That's a little bit more IT driven, but they have a comparison sheet in the admissions thing that you should check out. But you both are still totally computer science.
No idea.
All good.
I'm in my second year at the University of British Columbia.
Congratulations.
Studying Maybe Poli Sci.
Maybe Poli Sci. Great. I'm studying Welcome to the party. It's even more embarrassing in a class the first week of school. Don't worry. What are you interested in?
International diplomacy with a focus in foreign trade policy.
Cool. Specific. Very nice. So I'm in the government, which is within the Department of Politics, which you're in, like, possibly poli sci, so
yeah.
Welcome to the party. The thing, the, like, tracks within that are government and then foreign affairs. Foreign affairs is, like, the international relations
yeah.
side of it. With any of the politics majors, you have to take a set number of, like, IR classes. And with that, there are a ton of different classes to take. I love the politics department because I thought all of the classes were super interesting. Great professors and all have specific specialties. So go talk to them and see what you're interested in. You said with international trade too, right?
Yes.
Okay, a lot of the business classes are covered under the comm school, but then there are like classes about and like economics and all sorts of stuff that you could like focus on like different concentrations there too.
Now, are like the politics class, are they more so like discussion based or book based?
It really depends. I'll talk about classes or class size in just a sec, but with larger classes, you'll have a discussion. I'll break that down for you in a sec. But then a lot of politics classes, say if you only have like 30 people in a class, it'll be pretty discussion based. I took a class actually in this classroom last semester. It was my favorite I've taken at UVA so far, and it was on race in the Obama presidency. So it was kind of discussion based, but she'd also lecture at us with like what she wanted us to take away and stuff like that. And then we discussed it all, like different readings and stuff. But we'd sit in a circle, which like is a discussion based class, but she'd lecture for part of it too, which gives you a little bit of a picture of the smaller classes you'd be taking like your third and fourth year. I'll talk about all of that in a second though. Sure. What are you interested in?
Science.
Science, great. Maybe pre-med or just science for fun?
Medicine.
Cool. Great. Cool. All right, so So the thing I'll say with being pre-med or any sort of pre-health profession is that the Career Center is a great thing to know about. They have full-time advisors whose job it is to make sure you're on track for medical school if that's something you're interested in. That's also say you're true for if you're say pre-law and interested in like pursuing law school. They have people to make sure you're on track for filling requirements, volunteering if that's a component you'll need.
Cool.
Awesome.
I have a question regarding like majors though. I mean, you touched on it in the presentation. Like, what if you go into a super specialized school and you do a complete 180 and you change your mind?
Yes. With that, it's much better to go into the smaller school at first. I was talking to someone who's considering kinesiology, but might be considering drama too. And in that case, it'd be better to go into kinesiology and then get out if you decide you're not interested. But say if you're in the College of Arts and Sciences and you just have an epiphany and decide to do architecture one day, that's going to be a little bit trickier than being an architecture and deciding like, oh my gosh, I just want to major in economics. Then you can transfer back to the larger school pretty easily, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Cool. What are you interested in?
Law-ish.
Law-ish.
I mean,
aren't we all? All right. So for that, you can major in pretty much anything, English, economics, philosophy, politics, history, you probably know all of that already. But pre-law advising through the Career Center and through those like pre-professional tracks is awesome. And then just talking to advisors too, and a lot of those majors they deal with a lot of pre-law people too.
Theater and some sort of
awesome. Yeah, we talked about kinesiology through the Curry School too. Cool. And anybody else? No? Awesome. So hopefully that was like or shed a little bit of light on different programs you might be interested in. I'll talk a little bit about the largest class at UVA with class size, because I think that's one to talk about, and then research. So just to throw some numbers at you first, those are all in your little community handout that they gave you. We have 16,000 undergrads. That puts us at a medium to large university, depending how you shake it. Our student to faculty ratio is 16 to 1. And then this is the big one to know, the like actual number is printed out, but this is still true. Over 80% of our classes have 50 or fewer students, and over 50% of our classes have 20 or fewer students. That should give you some perspective in considering class sizes. Now, given that your first year, you'll probably have a larger lecture each semester, maybe a medium-sized one, a smaller class, and then a tiny seminar and another smaller seminar, maybe like writing in foreign language. It just sort of depends what you're pursuing. That'll be true through your second year. You'll take a mix of different academic environments. That's cool. You get to sample a bunch of different academic settings. And then your third and fourth year, the classes get smaller and smaller. As you're in your specific major, you pretty much know everyone in your class, which actually is a lot of fun. But with that, I'll talk about the largest class at UVA. I took it my first semester, and I think it was really indicative of what it's like to be a student here. So it is a microeconomics class, introduction to microeconomics taught by Kenneth Elzinga. It's a 500-person lecture. So walking in on my first day of class, I was pretty overwhelmed. I've heard really good things about the class, but it felt more like a small concert venue than it did a classroom. Walking in, I wasn't sure how I would get to know the material or the professor, and both of those were answered in really helpful ways that are true for other large classes too. With getting to know the professors, office hours are most helpful. So office hours are true of any class. For every hour a professor teaches during the week, they're required to have an hour sitting in their office waiting for students to show up. So with office hours, Professor Elzinga goes beyond the required number because he has so many students each semester. He'll bring a cooler full of goodies from Costco, cold Gatorades, waters, and snacks that make the wait a little bit easier. Once it's your turn, you can go in, get to know him. He's awesome. He's been teaching the class for over 40 years. One of the most experienced guys at UVA, which I think like busted a lot of the myths I had built up about people who are teaching the intro classes. He's awesome. The class is so big because people want to take him every year. But really personal guy. He'll ask you your name, hometown, what you're interested in, what it's like to be a first year or a fourth year, depending where you're at during your time here. And then any advising questions you might have, what to major in for my undecided row, or any sort of like career advice, he's great with that too, especially if you're interested in econ. But that's an awesome resource to know about. I found that professors have been very available to me, especially as an undergrad. They're there just waiting for their students to show up. And I find a lot of mentors do that, so that's been awesome. The other thing I'll mention with the larger classes are discussion sections. That means once a week for any class over 100 people, you're required to have an hour in a classroom just like this with just about this many students. With a TA, who's usually a grad student on their way to being a professor. It complements the larger lecture setting really nicely because you have a smaller classroom. They'll go over any of the lecture material, any stuff from the readings, clear up any questions, go over a lot of practice problems, stuff like that. And then they'll have quizzes too to make sure you're on track for the exams before you take it, which is really helpful. So that's a great resource too. TAs or teaching assistants host their own office hours as well. They're great for answering very specific questions about stuff you're going over. So through both of those things, I felt like I was able to learn just as much as I did in my smaller classes as I did in a 500-person microeconomics class. I totally recommend it, and that's why it's one of the most popular classes at UVA. The other thing I'll mention before Q&A time is research. UVA is a research institution. Coming in, that wasn't something I was looking for in a school. I thought research was only for people in math and science. It's not. Over 60% of students will participate in research during their time here. There's opportunities to get involved as soon as your first semester here. The Undergraduate Research Network is an awesome thing to know about. They have listings online of all of the departments and places looking for people to do research. From medieval studies to mathematics, there's research everywhere. I'd super recommend checking it out. There's stuff for credit or for pay. I went about a little bit of a different path in finding research. I took a seminar with a professor last fall, really liked him, and saw that he was doing a big research project on politics and religion. I was like, heck yeah, I'm interested. I sent him an email and was like, hi, do you have any opportunities? And he was like, yeah, come talk to me in my office. I have a part-time job out of it now, and that's been awesome. A great way to